Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Friday, January 28th. Here comes the snow. Winter weather alert coverage on air, online, on our free mobile app as an approaching storm will begin to impact the Garden State with some heavy snow beginning later this evening. Let's bring in our chief meteorologist, Dan Zero. Dan, things are starting to become a little clearer in terms of the track of this storm and the amount of snow that many areas are going to get. What do folks need to know about it this morning?
Well, we are getting slammed with snow. There's little doubt at this point that we've got a major winter storm on our hands, especially for New Jersey's coastal counties, where a blizzard warning has been issued from 7 p.m. tonight until 7 p.m. on Saturday. That doesn't necessarily have to do with how much snow falls. We're going to see 12 to 18 inches there along the shore. But when you combine the heavy snow with wind and low visibility, that can create dangerous, if not impossible, travel conditions. Farther inland, we'll see less snow, but still some good accumulation, still some dangerous conditions. The peak of the storm is going to be overnight, Friday night into Saturday. Things will finally taper off as we get into Saturday afternoon.
All right, Dan, thank you. And again, we will have continuing coverage, winter weather alert storm coverage, on air, online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. It's also worth noting, in addition to the snow, we are going to have some very dangerous cold with wind chills at zero or below. We will be monitoring throughout the night and throughout the weekend everything that you need to know. If you have not downloaded our mobile app yet, do it now. It's free. If the power does happen to go out, you'll still be connected to the information that you need to keep yourself and your family safe. An 11-year-old Mount Laurel boy has been flown to one of the top burn centers in the nation, the Shriners Hospital in Galveston, Texas. Ryan Jastrzemski suffered second and third degree burns on 90% of his body when he poured gasoline on a backyard bonfire and the gas can exploded. The survival rates for such extensive burns is low, but the Shriners Hospital may be the boy's best hope for recovery. He flew out with his mother on a medical plane this week. A GoFundMe page has been started to help the family with medical expenses. You can find out how you can help at nj1015.com this morning. New Jersey's rate of transmission and most COVID metrics have now dropped to levels we haven't seen since before the Omicron wave began. The CDC data tracker still lists every New Jersey county as having a high risk of COVID transmission, but the infection rates continue to fall. The RT is now at 0.58. Hospitalizations have dropped below 4,000. And again, we're seeing numbers nearing the lows prior to the Omicron wave. Kids having to wear a mask in school remains a very contentious issue in the Garden State. One of the legislature's newest voices is the latest to make noise over this issue. Should Governor Murphy decide whether kids have to mask up in school, or should that be a parental choice? State Senator Edward Durr, who in a surprising fashion beat Senate President Steve Sweeney in last November's election, is raising his voice on this issue. He says the CDC classifies masks as a medical device, and as such, it is not the governor's purview to decide if your child should have to use a medical device. That decision should be left solely to parents. You can read more on that story and what Durr had to say about it at nj1015.com. Meanwhile, some parents in the Hunterdon Central Regional School District are pushing back on the school's quarantine policy, especially as it pertains to unvaccinated students. The parents say it's a discriminatory policy that forces healthy, unvaccinated students with no symptoms but have had an exposure to still go home for at least 5 days, and they can't participate in sports or extracurricular activities for at least 11 days. Contrast that to the policy regarding a vaccinated student. Even with an exposure, if they show no symptoms, they can go right back to class. Legal weed sales were scheduled to begin next month, February 22nd, but it appears state regulators are going to miss that self-imposed deadline for a variety of reasons. Supply issues, questions over edibles, questions over permit applications. Some permit applicants have waited over 2 years. 14 new grow sites were approved in the last few months, but others are still waiting. The CRC will meet later this afternoon, but they don't appear any closer to getting the regulatory market ready to go in the Garden State for recreational sales, and it may still be months yet before it is available. Do you still have your Christmas lights up? You drive around the Garden State and you'll see quite a few lights outside, and some people still have their trees up inside. Our Jeff Dominski has taken note of it and is exploring why the lights seem to be up a little bit longer this year. It could be that we just need a little extra holiday cheer. You can check out his article at NJ1015.com this morning. If you have something to say about our top stories, leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey, on air on New Jersey 101.5. And as for this storm, we will keep you updated tonight and throughout the entire weekend, on air, online, on our free mobile app. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's first news for this Friday, January 28th. Have a safe weekend and stay warm.